Yeah. If you want to convert the temperature from degrees Celsius to the Fahrenheit or to Kelvin, these are the factors, okay? Kelvin to Celsius is adding of 273. Fahrenheit, Celsius to Fahrenheit is 9/5 degree Celsius plus 32. This is the conversion factor. Suppose you are going to the doctor.
Second.
Yeah.
Sir, can you give some examples about the Fahrenheit and Kelvin?
I'll give you those examples. Don't worry about that. Next one is the... Okay. Generally, if you take Fahrenheit scale, where it will start?
From 32 degrees Fahrenheit.
It will start from 32 degrees Fahrenheit to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit scale always starts from 32 degrees Fahrenheit to the 212 degrees Fahrenheit. What about the Celsius scale?
From 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius.
To 100 degrees Celsius. What about the Kelvin scale?
273 degrees Kelvin to 373 degrees Kelvin.
It starts from 273 Kelvin. If you take 100 means, that is a 373 Kelvin. Okay. Okay. You can zoom in your phone or laptop. That's better.
No, so it's already zoomed out, I'm saying.
Okay, I can't do more than this because it is a picture, right?
Okay.
If I zoom out, it will go again. Now it's okay?
Okay.
It is better. Okay. Now we have the three scales. First one is the Kelvin scale. Second one is the Celsius scale. And the third one is the Fahrenheit scale. Can you see clearly or not? First thing.
Yes, sir, we can see
clearly.
It is so clear, sir.
Middle one is the Celsius scale. The 0 degree centigrade is called the freezing point of water. What is the freezing point of water?
0 degrees Celsius.
0 degrees Celsius and Fahrenheit is 30 degrees
Celsius. No. What is the freezing point of water? Conversion from liquid to solid form, right?
Yes, sir. Liquid to solid form.
Liquid to solid form is called as a freezing point. So generally, the water will have the freezing point of 0 degrees Celsius. At the same time, in terms of Fahrenheit, that is a 32 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes?
Okay, sir.
But at the same time, in the Kelvin scale is equal to the 273.15 Kelvin. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
The 0 degrees is equal to the 32 degrees Fahrenheit, or else it is equal to the 273 Kelvin. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, we'll come to the next point, that is the room temperature. If the Celsius degree is 25 degrees Celsius room temperature, what about the Fahrenheit?
So it's 77 degrees Fahrenheit.
It is a 77 degrees Fahrenheit. In the Kelvin?
So it's 298
Kelvin. Next one is the human body temperature. Human body temperature means normal human body temperature.
That is 77 degrees Celsius.
In terms of Fahrenheit?
Sir, 98.6
degrees Fahrenheit. Now, suppose you are going to the doctor. Suppose you have the fever. He is measuring the temperature of your body. He will say as 99 or 100 degrees Celsius, right? Sorry, Fahrenheit, right?
Simply
he will say Fahrenheit. He will not say Fahrenheit also. He will say it's a 99 or 100 or 101. He will say like these numbers only.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But what is the number?
Yes, sir.
What scale he is saying that when?
Sir, Fahrenheit.
In Fahrenheit, sir.
Fahrenheit.
In the Fahrenheit. Okay, it is not in the Celsius. If you say 103 as a high fever, that scale is in the Fahrenheit. Understanding? It is not in the Celsius. If you take
one doubt, sir.
Yeah.
If we'll go to doctor, means they will say 103 means high fever, they will say like that, sir. Yeah. How can you see that is high fever 103 degrees?
Because normal body temperature is 98 only, right? 98 degrees Fahrenheit,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
So based upon their scale 103 or 102, they will say it's a high fever.
Okay.
But if it's when you are checking up the during the normal temperature, normal body or normal time, it will be around 99 or 97 or 98.
Okay.
Understanding.
Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, someone. Akshit?
Any sir, doubt? I have a doubt. Sir, for tomorrow's exam, what's the syllabus?
Yeah, sorry, Akshit. That one, tomorrow's exam portion is the same. Matter and surroundings.
Okay,
sir. Whatever you are studying in the class only, I'll ask you the exam. That's all.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Okay
sir, exam is today, right?
So, but some other people are saying have some other work. So, I'll connect tomorrow itself directly.
Okay, sir. Is it evening?
Yeah, it's evening time only. Okay. If you are okay today, now I will connect today itself. There is no issue in that. But it will take some time.
Sir, no, sir. I need tomorrow. I have some other.
Okay, okay. No problem in that. Now it is clear. Conversion from Kelvin to Celsius to Fahrenheit.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. What is the boiling point?
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening, sir.
So, children, how are you all? I am finding most of you have turned off your videos.
Sir,
we have given you a strict warning. If it is turned off, we will remove, and at any cost, you cannot join for the classes.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, I am turned.
So, is it clear for Kelvin scale, Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale?
Yes, sir.
Still anyone has doubts in this?
No doubts, sir.
No doubts, sir.
No doubts. So, you can see the conversion factor also. Fahrenheit scale is equal to 9/5, Celsius plus 32. Okay? So, is the conversion factors from the Fahrenheit to Celsius or Celsius to the Kelvins. It is very, very important in the chemistry conversion factor and all. Okay, we'll come back to the topic.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you see the whiteboard?
Sir, totally it is.
Yes, sir.
Totally.
Yeah, now?
Now it is okay, sir.
It's okay now, sir.
Sir, can you give some examples like Fahrenheit and Kelvin?
Suppose if you want to convert from, I have given the temperature like 27 degrees Celsius. Can you tell me the same in the Fahrenheit? Sorry, it's difficult in the Fahrenheit. Otherwise, take in the Kelvin. So convert this 27 degrees Celsius into the Kelvin.
The 300
Kelvin. 300,
sir.
300 Kelvin. The same thing if you do in the Fahrenheit now is a 9/5 into 27 plus 32. How much you'll get? Faiza?
5.4
into 9, how much? Do the calculation portion, tell me that.
48.6
plus 32. What is the answer?
Sir, 80.6.
So the answer is in the Fahrenheit, how much?
80.6 degrees Fahrenheit.
80.6 degrees Fahrenheit.
Degrees Fahrenheit.
Understand. Like this, you have to convert.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you for giving the exam.
Suppose if I say 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Convert into the Celsius. What you will do?
Minus 32 into 5/9.
100 into 100 minus 32. Overall into 5/9, right?
Okay.
Is it clear for everyone?
Yes.
See here.
Yes.
That's yes, sir.
F minus 32 first we'll take is equal to 9/5 degrees Celsius. Now, when you're taking the left side to the right, sorry, right side to the left side of the equal to, it will become reverse. The numerator will change to denominator. Denominator will change to the numerator. So F minus 32 into 5/9 is equal to the degree Celsius. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now what is the answer here? 68 into 5 by 9. What is the calculation part fast?
60. So it's approximately
37.7, sir.
Yes.
7.7, sir.
7 degrees Celsius. Now you understand the conversion factors?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rishikesh, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Rishikesh, you can ask doubts at any point of time in the class. There is no issue, okay? Raise your hand and you can ask me the doubts.
Okay, sir.
Okay, don't feel shy and all in asking the doubts. If you feel the shy, it's not only to the Rishikesh. Anyone, if you feel shy in the asking the doubts now, it will be loose for you only. So whenever you have the doubts, any small doubts can clarify there itself. So what is the next one? In the last class, we discussed about the operation, 5 important points. What are those?
Sir, temperature, surface area, humidity, wind speed, nature of liquid.
One by one, okay? So first one is the temperature. If you increase the temperature, the evaporation rate will increase.
Decrease.
Surface area, also same.
Faster.
If you increase the surface area of a liquid, the evaporation rate also will increase.
Increase.
Next one, humidity, inversely proportional, right? If there is more humidity, the evaporation will be less.
Less.
If there is a less humidity, the evaporation will be?
Increase.
More.
More.
And the wind speed. Wind speed also directly proportional to the?
More wind speed.
The more wind speed will be there, the more evaporation rate will also be there. Okay?
Excuse me, sir.
And what about the last one? Nature of the liquid. So generally, volatile liquids will evaporate faster than the non-volatile liquids. Examples of volatile liquids?
Petrol.
Petrol.
Acetone.
Sorry, what is another example?
Kerosene.
Acetone.
Kerosene will not evaporate easily, right?
Sir, acetone.
So what about petrol?
Yeah, acetone, something you can say as that one.
Sir, diesel.
Diesel also will not evaporate easily. If you keep the diesel in the open atmosphere, no, it will not evaporate like petrol.
So, sir, water?
Water also, no. Non-volatile, right?
So, you have written example as water and petrol.
No, water and petrol means this is the petrol is for the volatile. Water is for
sir, liquefied camphor.
Yeah.
I have observed while I was doing my morning prayers.
Chloroform also is example for the liquids. Okay, so these are the common basic examples in our surroundings. I am explaining here. Okay,
yes, sir.
Volatile liquids also evaporate very fast compared to the non-volatile liquids. Next, what is the sublimation?
Sir, can alcohol also be?
It is the ability to change from solid state to gaseous state.
Ability to change from the
solid state to gaseous state without. Liquid state.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah. So, what is the solid to liquid?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, Mohit. Someone?
Yes, sir. It's Kavya, sir. Sir, if an exam is that question, why is water at room temperature in liquid form? What shall I write?
Why is water?
In liquid form at room temperature.
Because room temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, right?
Sir, but water is already liquid, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. Yeah, because at the room temperature, the energy with the water molecules are higher. But at the 0 degrees Celsius, it will become the solid form, right? At this time, the intermolecular energy is lesser in the water. Understanding? During the kinetic energy of matter, we discussed the Ke factor.
Yes, sir.
The kinetic energy of the particles will depends upon the temperature.
Yes, sir.
If there is more kinetic energy, the particles will move continuously, right?
Yes, sir.
If there is a less kinetic energy, the particles will move non-continuous or they will not move at all. If you increase the temperature, the kinetic energy will increase. Means at 25 degrees Celsius, the kinetic energy of the particles are higher, right?
Yes, sir.
Compared to the 0 degrees Celsius.
Yes, sir.
That's why the water will be in the liquid format at the room temperature.
Sir, and also, what produces sewer burns? Boiling water or steam?
Generally, boiling water or the?
Steam. So the answer is steam, sir.
Steam itself.
So the answer is steam.
Because the boiling water will be different based upon the atmospheric pressure. Yes?
Yes,
sir.
If there is more, the boiling point of the water also will increase. And the atmospheric pressure is less, the boiling point of the water also decrease. That's what we already discussed at this point in the class. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Kavya.
Yes, sir.
Okay, shall we continue with the topic here?
No? Sir, but when we take steam, sir? Sir, but when we take steam during colds, when we have cold or fever, we take steam, right?
Yeah.
So, like, why don't we get burns then?
We will not.
We take steam, so why don't we get burns?
But we will take the steam higher from the long distance, right? At least some distance will keep, right? Yes or no? Instead of keeping the hand in the boiling water, we are directly touching the boiling water. Then only you will start burning. But if you keep the hot steam air near the nose, it will start burning only, right? We'll keep it some distance that way.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
So, are alcohol and medical spirits also volatile? Because if you leave them open, they will evaporate.
Yeah, all the alcohols are not volatile in nature, but most of the alcohols are there, volatile in nature. Spirit also. That's why the smell will spread easily.
Yes,
if you go to the hospital, if they are using the spirit in one place, it will spread easily, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is also volatile nature. So solid to liquids, what is the fact? What is it? Name?
So it is melting.
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 What about the liquid to solid?
So freezing.
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 Liquid to gas?
Evaporating.
Evaporation, sir.
Evaporation.
Boiling.
What about the gas to liquid?
So condensation.
Condensation.
Say evaporation and boiling are two different things.
Evaporation and the boiling are.
So they are different, right?
Different only. Yeah. The boiling point will be different exactly, and the operation is different.
Is a boiling is a bulk phenomenon and evaporation
is a surface phenomenon.
Surface phenomenon.
Evaporation is a surface phenomenon. Okay. Yeah.
Yes.
And yeah.
It liquid to gas can be both evaporation and boiling, right?
Sorry.
So, the conversion of a liquid to gas can be both evaporation and boiling, right?
Yeah, boiling will also come, but boiling is then based upon the temperature.
Okay.
And the operation is on surface phenomenon. You can say both, no problem in that. And the gases to the liquid is the?
So, condensation.
Condensation. What about the solid to gas?
So solid to gas is
sublimation.
Then gases to solid?
Deposition.
That's what is a very important point here. Don't confuse between the condensation and the deposition. That's why I'm going to start.
There in some books, they also write gases to solid as deposition. Sorry, sublimation.
Gases to solid is not the sublimation exactly, but it's the deposition. The exact term.
Okay, sir.
Okay, generally you will find these terms, freezing, melting, evaporation, but you won't find these two terms, sublimation and deposition.
So I thought it was reposition. No.
Sorry?
So I thought it was reposition.
Deposition, not okay. Reposition.
Okay, sir.
Okay, these are conversion factors. Any doubts in this?
No, sir, no doubts.
Okay. So, this is all about the conversion from.
So, can you give an example of deposition?
Deposition. Suppose if you go to the cold climate.
Okay, sir.
The fog will deposit on the glass of the wind, glass of the cars, right?
Yes, sir.
Form the solid ice.
Yes, sir.
That is a deposition. Water vapor will form the solid ice on the glass.
Not even dry ice.
Yeah, dry ice also example good.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The solid CO2 is called as in dry ice. So without going to the liquid state, it will form directly go into the solid state. That is called as in deposition. Okay. Still anyone has doubts?
No, sir, I have said that. Can you, I am confusing with what we should take example of sublimation, sir.
Camphor.
Camphor.
Suppose if you burn the camphor, what will happen?
I don't know. I am
camphor, you know, right? First. Huh? Camphor are naphthalene tablets.
Yes, sir.
Naphthalene balls.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Naphthalene balls also will move from directly from solid form to gaseous form.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Camphor also same. If you start burning the camphor, it will not convert to liquid. It will go directly to the gaseous state.
Okay. Sir, like, why is it only in these things, whereas not in other things?
It's a conversion factor, right? Interchangeable factor for the two states of matter. Solid to liquid is happening, or liquid to gas is happening. At the same time, there are some substances which will go from solid to gas also.
Yes, sir. I mean, is it like the temperature is way too hot for them?
No, it's not about the temperature and all. It depends upon the molecular level also, the particles levels.
Okay, so the sir.
Micro level also still depends upon. Generally, the conversion of one state of matter to other state of matter based upon the temperature only, right? Temperature and pressure. Yes or no? If you increase the temperature only, now solid will convert to liquid, or liquid to convert to gas. If you decrease the temperature now, the gases will convert to liquid, or liquid converts to the solid. So it's again the temperature effect will comes under the kinetic theory of matter. That is the kinetic energy.
Okay, sir. And sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, Mohit.
Yes, sir. So are perfumes volatile in nature?
Perfumes are volatile. Perfume first is a gaseous state, right?
So aren't they in liquid state, sir, like when you release them?
So before they're released, they're in their liquid state, right?
Yeah, yeah. So generally, some perfumes are volatile in nature because they are inflammable only, right? Mostly.
Yes, yeah, sir.
Generally, mostly inflammable liquids are volatile in nature only.
Okay, sir.
First, do you know the difference of inflammable and flammable?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yeah, flammable is like normally can catch fire. Inflammable can easily catch fire or have low boiling points.
Generally, both are will catch fire easily. But inflammable
is
the lowest
ignition temperature.
Or ignition temperature.
Somewhat higher ignition temperature. So most of the inflammable liquids are having the volatile nature.
Okay, sir.
Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Still anyone doubts in this topic? Shall we move to next topic?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I already informed you, right, about the gas laws. So our next topic is the gas laws. We have the 3 to 4 laws are there. In that, first one is a Boyle's law. Anybody knows what is the Boyle's law?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. So at constant temperature, this is the definition of Boyle's law. At constant temperature, the pressure of the gas is inversely proportional to volume. What is the Boyle's law? Pressure is inversely proportional to volume. Understand this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I did not understand.
The Boyle's law states, or Boyle's law given the relationship between the pressure and the volume. If you keep the temperature constant, the pressure of the gas is inversely proportional to its volume. If you increase the pressure, the volume of the gas will decrease, right? Suppose you have taken one beaker and you have taken one piston. Inside the beaker, there is a gas. if you apply the more pressure here, what will happen? The piston will move inside, right? Inside the beaker? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If you increase the pressure, the volume of the gas is decreasing or increasing?
Increasing.
Decreasing only, right? Here the same amount of gas is there. Here also the same amount of gas is there. But the volume is decreasing. Understanding?
Yes, sir. Got it.
This is explained by the Boyle's law. So what is the Boyle's law? At constant temperature,
the pressure of gas inversely proportional to the volume.
The pressure of the gas occupied is, okay, we'll write occupied.
Okay, sir.
Is inversely proportional to the
volume.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you remove this proportionality constant, what will happen? Can take
sir, can you once go up?
Yeah, once I will explain this topic, I will scroll up that one, okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So this is a proportionality constant, right? Some constant. So if you remove the proportionality constant, we'll take as a sum of constant as a k into 1 by b. What is k here? It can be any constant value. Now, if you bring this v to this side, what will happen? Pv equal to constant only, right? Are you understanding? Or you can write as a p dot v equal to k only, right? Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
What is this k? K is a constant only.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
K full form is
k is constant only, right? So, suppose if you have two gases. First gas has the pressure P1 and the volume V1. Second gas has the pressure P2 and the volume V2. Then you can make as a P1, V1 is equal to constant. And second gas, P2, V2 is equal to constant, right?
Yes, sir.
So both the constants are same. So P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. Can you make like this?
Yes, sir. We can do it.
Clear now?
So where did you get P2, V2 from?
This is for second gas.
Okay. So we are mixing both gases.
Or else? You'll take like this. First, we have the pressure P1 here. And the volume of the gas is occupied V1.
Okay, sir.
After applying some more pressure, the pressure become P2, right?
Okay, sir. Okay, got it.
Now the volume become V2, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the relationship between these two?
Sir, this is more pressed and this is more compressed and this is less compressed.
So the pressure is more, the volume is less and the pressure is same.
Yeah, that is only expressed by this only, right? P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2.
Okay, sir, got it.
Yes, sir.
Understand?
Yes, sir, got it.
So what is the Boyle's law? Pressure is inversely proportional to the volume of the
gas.
You can copy this one.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, is k is equal to 1?
K can be anything constant. Either it can be 1 or it can be 2.
Oh, okay, sir.
But it can be constant value only for both the cases.
All right, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Can I give one question on this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Suppose note on one question. A 17.50 ml sample of a gas is at 4.500 atmosphere pressure. What will be the volume. If the pressure becomes 1.5 atmosphere, at the constant temperature. What is the answer?
Sir, it is like 17.50 into 4.5 divided by 1.5.
Suppose you have taken the solution like this. First, we have the one gas beaker is there. One piston is there. So what is the volume of the gas at this time? V1, 17.50 ml at the pressure of 4.5 atmosphere, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, whether the pressure is increased or decreased?
Decreased, sir.
Decreased. Decreased means the piston will go up or down? The piston will go up, right?
Up.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This is a beaker. Yes, sir. Now, the pressure becomes P2, how much?
1.5.
1.5. What do you have to find out?
Volume. Sir, it is 52.5.
It's 52.5, sir.
52.5.
So already we have the three variables are given. They're asking for the fourth unknown variable. So P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. Find out fast, everyone. 1.5 into V2.
Into V2.
The V2 is equal to
52.5 divided by 1.5.
52.5? Yes, sir. So the answer is 52.5.
Everybody got the answer?
Yes, sir.
Yes. By 1.5, sir, that is equal to 52.5.
What is the answer?
52.5
ml. Why?
Everybody got 5
ml, so yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everybody got the answer, or still anyone has doubts?
No doubts.
No doubts, sir.
Clear? What is the Boyle's law?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Clear. Sure.
Next, we'll go for the Charles law.
So, what is that?
Charles law.
Charles law.
So these all concepts are going to come in the test.
Sorry? Yeah, one thing I forgot about the test, right? So the test will be complete, syllabus will be there from the starting onwards.
Sir, but we don't...
They're including this, class. Right?
Not including this. Excluding this only. Gas loss.
Sir?
Yeah.
But we don't have this laws in books.
Yeah, we don't have the
that law. That is why sir is explaining.
That's what it is, extra concepts for the competitive exam point of view. That's why I'm explaining here. Okay. These are useful for the competitive exams. Olympiad exams are the JEE exams.
Okay. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, Harini.
Sir, this Charles law will come under gas law only, sir.
Yeah, Charles law will come under the gas laws. Next, Avogadro's law will be there. Boyle's law.
What is this law, sir? I am not able to fill this. This is upper one.
Boyle's law. Okay. Next one is the Charles law. Next one is the Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law. So from when you are combining all the three laws, you will get the ideal gas equation.
Ideal gas equation.
Yeah, I will tell you that one by one. Don't worry.
Sir, only three laws are there.
Yeah, three laws are there. So when you're combining all the three laws, you'll get the ideal gas equation.
Okay, sir.
So this will be the last portion of our chapter, this chapter, matter and surroundings. Okay.
As per the NCERT, how many chapters are combined? Now we are explaining, no, sir.
So I'm compiling first two chapters.
First. Okay, sir.
So the first I explained for the compound and the mixture also, right? In this only. Okay, so apart from the compound and mixture in the second chapter, I will explain what are the differentiation techniques and all in the next class. I mean, after this completion of this topic.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Still anyone has doubts?
No, sir.
No. And for the test, you have the complete portion from the starting to the ending, except this last. So up to the phase change, you have the test portion. So again, you are asking the extra time. You can study for today night also. And don't expect the direct questions in the test. The same thing you have done in the test number 2. I hope you understand how the questions are formed in the test number 2, indirect way. The same way the questions will come for this test also.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so read the question properly and try to attempt the answer. And everyone write the test only in the Wise app and submit the
test. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, till when is the test available, sir?
The test will be available tomorrow evening. So you have the 5:15 to 6:15 class is there, right? After the 6:15 time, it will be available.
Okay,